What if we could prevent all diseases?
How do we use artificial intelligence to truly transform human health, to make aging optional, to make disease a thing of the past?
What if your entire genome could be mapped out?
It already feels like I've walked into a science fiction movie.
What if we can live forever?
We are on the brink of immortality.
The Abu Dhabi Genome Project wants to answer all of this. It's going to decode its country's genetic blueprint to revolutionize healthcare. From preventing diseases to creating personalized treatments, this insanely bold initiative could redefine the future of medicine, starting here. I've spent several months researching how AI is being used across the UAE, and nothing is surprising me more than the advancements in the genomics sector. What I truly believe will be a game changer for the country and even the world. Through the research being done here, the UAE is planning to create one of the world's largest and most diverse DNA databases for a completely modernized healthcare system that'll be driven by tech, data aggregation, and AI. The benefits of this could lead to improved health outcomes globally, but also advancements in medicine, more personalized healthcare approaches, early cancer and chronic illness detection. And for the first time in history, this data will be centered around the Arab world and their genetic composition. I'm next to Mohammed bin Zayed University of Artificial Intelligence. It's next door to the headquarters of the UAE's groundbreaking genomics lab, where this is all unfolding. To put it simple, genomics is the study of our DNA, how it interacts with medicine, how it causes disease, and how it affects overall health when combined with artificial intelligence. Genomics research here looks like these futuristic machines processing thousands of terabytes worth of genetic sequencing information from as little as a vial of blood. These machines are able to process more data in a few minutes than what humans are capable of processing in a lifetime.
Each single human being has 3.2 billion data points per whole genome. When you multiply that by over 600,000 genomes, it's petabytes, which means thousands and thousands of terabytes and so on and so forth. That is a large amount of data that has to be secured, and we have to pull insights from this.
The amount of data these machines are able to process is crazy because it allows researchers to discover more genetic predispositions to conditions and then design personalized plans tailored to patient healthcare needs.
From identifying a target, i.e. knowing that there's a disease and a problem here, to bringing a drug to market, 10 to 15 years. With the tools that we have available to us in AI acceleration, every one of those stages could typically be accelerated, and we can hopefully bring a drug to market within maybe 5 years.
It's not just acceleration of drug development, though. It's also the cost of collecting the data that's made the entire process more efficient. Genomics research is backed by billions of dollars. This blend of funding fuels cutting-edge facilities, groundbreaking research, and the very lab I'm standing in. Though exact numbers have not been made public, reports have indicated this genomics endeavor, being called the Emirati Genome Program, is a multi-billion dollar investment. Behind this innovation is the largest UAE-based AI tech group, G42, and the Mubadala Investment Company. They created M42 and strategically partnered with major tech companies like Microsoft and the Broad Institute of MIT and Harvard to use their tech platforms for secure data platforms and analytics. They're also partnering with AWS and pharmaceutical companies like AstraZeneca. All to say, with so many big investors, there is a lot at stake here. But most of all, if genomics research doesn't deliver some sort of return on investment, it will be a huge missed opportunity, especially for the Arab population.
Currently, 90% of all clinical trials are conducted on only 10% of the world's ethnicity. That means the medication myself of Arabic ethnicity or Middle Eastern ethnicity takes might not work for me because that trial was conducted on a different ethnicity. So there is an inequity when it comes to the data that is available for clinical trials and the clinical trials itself. So we have an imbalance. The FDA, for example, is trying to push for more variety of data sets of different ethnicities to make these clinical trials more conducive to population health and population treatment, not just specific treatment of specific locations.
In collecting data of populations that we've never had before, this means we could actually see medical solutions to diseases and health issues that predominantly hit Arab populations the hardest. All this is about to change though, and I really want to know, how will people feel about handing over something as personal as their DNA, all for the promise of groundbreaking medicine? The UAE has been aggressive with their public outreach and PR campaigning for the Emirati Genome Program. Doing outreach at conventions, public spaces, and online, they say the key to getting participation is through education.
So we do a lot of training and education awareness activities. So we go out to the communities and our outreach team actually builds awareness by educating the local communities on what we're doing.
Would you give your blood to a lab for research purposes with no immediate guarantee of any benefits? Well, apparently a lot of Emiratis already have. Recent reports show that 500,000 people voluntarily participated with samples, but this is still pretty far off from the country's goal of 10 million participants. And get this, they're also targeting the unborn. One fascinating component of genetic testing is for DNA of unborn babies, something that could really prepare a family for what to expect if a genetic predisposition were detected.
We take the mother's blood, and we're checking for the fetus's DNA in the mother's blood. And so a non-invasive way of checking on the genetic makeup of that baby before the baby's born, because there could be genetic disorders that the physician treating the mother or the expecting mother would like to know, make decisions based on that information.
But as with any data, there's potential for hacks, cyber attacks, information falling into the wrong hands, human error. I'm pretty surprised to learn that the government has been pretty proactive in addressing security issues. In fact, they've even created federal legislation around the protection, ethical use, and governance of genetic data, as well as standards for data privacy, consent, and how to securely handle biological samples. If you've lived in the UAE though, you'll know that data privacy isn't the only concern on people's minds. In a country deeply rooted in religion and motivated by God's will, new technologies and innovations aren't always met with open arms, but based on his research, he doesn't see it like that.
I actually feel completely the opposite of that. They thrive for that awareness and understanding. So build that awareness within your community, then the decision is for the individual, as we all know, right? So now giving them that information, you'll be surprised that brings awareness to the community and how they react to that awareness.
The Emirati Genome Program is still young, so there are many things still to figure out, but here's my take. I do feel a little bit nervous about what would happen if there was a data breach, but I also think it's worth the risk. Progress only happens when we take risks and push ideas. I think the risk versus reward here is justified, as there's so much potential upside that we can learn from this research. As I get a front row seat to learn about this AI-driven tech, I could see the vision of equitable care tailored to the people of the UAE, but one day designed to be scalable on a global level.